Okay guys, welcome to my YouTube channel Marigold David Marigold Bold. Guys, now we're going to solve I just solved the last questions, number 6, number 7 and number 8. Number 6, it's about Johnson counter and ring counter, which is type of shifter register. Question 6a, they say sketch a 4-bit Johnson counter and give the state sequence for 1 second. So this question, you can find the sketch in your textbook, even the state sequence, but I already do it for you also. You can just get it from this side. It's question number 6a. So question number 6a, you can see this is a Johnson counter. It's a Johnson counter. The Johnson counter is because they say 4-bit, so 4-bit, that will have 4 flip-flops, and then it's a synchronized device, that why all these clocks are connected together. And then what happened, the Johnson, the connection, the Q output of one flip-flop is connected to the Q to the input of the next flip-flop, and then the first flip-flop, the input of the first flip-flop is connected to the Q naught of the last flip-flop. This is the Johnson counter. And then what happened the Johnson counter with the state sequence? The state sequence actually is in the textbook. You can cram, or I will show you how what happened. We always start at zero. The counter start at zero if they didn't give you any sequence. In this case, we start at zero because we put everything at zero, zero. This is the beginning, that's why I say clock zero. And then what happens, we start shifting. When we shift, you're going to have this part will be empty, because if you shift, you shift this part, there won't be anything here. So you start fooling everything. When you shift, you fool by one. You shift, you fool by one, until you have one, one everywhere, like in the row, clock four. And then after that, you start shifting. Now we're still in the first circle, we start shifting again. And then when we shift again, we fool now with zero. You fool now with zero, and then you stop where you're going to have zero, zero everywhere in every queue output. And the last one, and the last one, you have one. That's how you're going, where you're going to stop. So you can see, guys, how this thing is very easy. So let's go to question number 6b. 6b, they say sketch a ring counter. So saying a ring counter of 5-bit, so 5-bit, that's why we have 5 flip-flops here. And then same thing like a Johnson counter, the Q output is connected to the next to the input of the next flip-flop. And then what happened also is a synchronized divided by all clock are connected together. But the only difference in this ring counter, we have clear and pre. So what happened, pre is connected to the first flip-flop and the red is connected to clear. That's why I connect this one first one to pre, and the last one I connect with clear. And then what happened with the ring counter, and then you can see the input of the first flip-flop is connected to the Q output of the last flip-flop. And then what happened this side, because they give you, and then the question, the other question of 6b, they say, well, the ring counter as the initial state of 10010 determine the counter sequence for 6 clock pulses. So they say 6 clock pulses, that are 0, 1, 2, 3, up to 6. You must always start by 0, because that 0 is the initial. Do not start by 1 first. Start please by 0, because we each and everything, we have initial state. Even life, we begin somewhere. We must start somewhere before we, because I don't know, whatever. So that's a problem. So you put everything here on the initial state. They give you the initial state, and then what happened, we start shifting. And then when you shift, you shift, you shift, what happened, this place will be empty, and this zero in the ring counter come and close, the last digit will come and close there. If you shift again, this last one, like this one, will come and close here. This is how the ring counter work. And then they say six clock pulse, so you stop at number 6. And then let's go to question 7. Question 7, they say, I'll design a divider by 45, 300 counter, and then the other one they say 41,550 counter using this logic diagram, which is 74HC 161 4-bit binary counter in the figure below. So this question, how we solve this question? First, you must know how many, because in this question they give you already like a clue. They give you 4-bit, which is like, you know that 4-bit, you have 4 flip, you have 4 logic symbol. So actually, how we get this 1616? You must first know how many logic symbol you're going to have in your design, because in this question they already give you that, why you know that it's 4-bit, but you must know. So what happened? One logic symbol is equal to 16. So if that number I'm going to get the one that the number that I need to get here at the end must be equal to the number that they give me here, 45,300 must be equal to that number or must be greater but not less. So if I use 16 is not equal to 45,300. If I add another logic symbol and multiply, it's gonna give me 296, something like that. So that number is still less than 45,300. If I add another flip-flop, another logic symbol is going to give me, I think, 4096, something like that, still less than this one, so I can't use that one. And when I add another one, it's give me 65,536. I can see this number is not equal to this number, but at least it's greater than this one, so this is the right number, which means I'm going to have four logic symbol in my design. And then I take that number, I subtract with the number that they give me, here in the question. And then when I subtract, I get the answer of 20,236. I just write 10 here because of decimal, it's a decimal number. And then you take that number, you convert in hexadecimal. After converting hexadecimal, you convert in binary, or you can convert state in binary if you want. And then after that, this connection doesn't change here. The connection that what changed, maybe if it's a 5-bit, or I don't know if there's another, if only maybe a number of logic symbol can change. Maybe it can be 3, maybe it can be more. So what, the connection doesn't change. So what happened now, you just take this number in binary, you put there in your input of each of logic symbol, but you start by less significant bit, which is C. You put C and then 0 and then F, which is 111, and then 4 in binary. So you can see how is it easy, this question. And then you go back, and then they say 7B, the same question, and like 7A. So you can, I won't explain again, so it's the same thing, but the solve it is this one. And then now let's go to question 8. Question 8, they say show with general block diagram how to achieve each of the following using flip-flop, decade counter, a 2-bit binary counter, or any combination of these. So the question say, they said you must, in this question they say that you must draw or sketch or a block diagram, but regarding in a relationship with these numbers that they give you, 880 and 160. What you must know, the rule, when you combine to one block, you have 3 block diagram here, which is, we have flip-flop, three single block diagram, I can say, I don't know, but it's fine. The first one is flip-flop, you must know flip-flop is equal to 2-bit binary counter is equal to 4, and decade counter is equal to 10. So you must know, if you combine these two, for example, I combine flip-flop and decade, there's a multiplication between the two. So now they said you must do the block diagram that is correspond to 880 and 160. So if I want to have 80, because flip-flop is 2, 2-bit binary counter is 4, So because between, if I combine the two blocks, it's going to give me what? If I combine the two blocks, it's going to give me 8, because it's a multiplication between the diagram, between the block. So that's why this is my first block is my first block diagram. The first block, you can design your own way if maybe you can want to make things more nice, I don't know, but this is the right way also. And then because 2 times 4 give me 8, that I get there with the first one. The second one is flip-flop times 4, which give me 8 times decade, which is 10, is give me 80. You can see 80 for the second one. The last one is 160. So I just take 4 times 4, give me 16, and then times 10, which is decade, give me 160. For question B, so you can combine it anyway, like question two also I can use maybe 2 flip-flop, 2 times 2 is giving it's going to give me 4, and then I can add another one, 4 times 2. I can use 3 flip-flops, it's going to give me 8 times 10, which is a decade, still give me 80. So guys, now we are at the end of our tutorial. I'll go back there on top so that I can stop maybe one second. So this is the first one, you can press pause and then copy down. You go this one also, you can press pause and copy down. Come also for 6A, you can press pause and then copy down. You can come here, you press 6B, you can press pause and then copy down. And the last one, you can come here, you press pause and then you copy down. So now we are at the end. So guys, thank you for watching my videos, and then I think this thing will help you, and then I think you're going to get full marks for your tutorial. And then please don't like to subscribe and share the link to your friend. Those also we need help. Don't keep the answers for you guys. It's not only you that want to pass, all of you guys want to pass. Please share the link to others, and then thank you. I think you'll pass this semester in the name of Jesus. And then please don't forget to subscribe and like the video. Thank you, bye.